Hello students, this is Isabella from St. Joseph College of Arts and Science. This video is for American literature. Today we can see the poem Meadow Mouse, which was written by Theodore Roethke. Before entering into poem, I would like to give small introduction about an author. Theodore Roethke was born on May 25, 1908 in Saginaw, Michigan. He is son of Otto Theodore and Helen Mary. He married Beatrice Heath O'Connell on January 3, 1953. He educated at University of Michigan. So move on to influences on Roethke's writing. Roethke grew up in the little house which built by his father and his uncle. So being brought up in a greenhouse, his childhood was fully surrounded and covered by plants and pretty like creatures, which must be reason he has learned to love these creatures so much. At age of 14, Roethke's father died and he left subconsciously feeling a sense of abandonment. So next, the significant works of Theodore Roethke. The famous books are Open House, The Lost Son and Other Poems, Praise to the End, The Waking, etc. The famous poems are My Papa's Waltz, Pickle Belt, Journey to the Interior, In a Dark Night, and etc. This poem is about people come and go, but life goes on. The similar thing happens in our life, but life doesn't stop there. Whatever happens in our life, it may struggle or happiness, it moves on. We have to learn and accept the fact what is happening in our life, and we have to just move on from that. So it is also one of the moving poem with use of imaginary, which gives us the visual impact and help us to feel the emotions more effectively. The poem begins with crystal description, I mean clear description of the mouse, how it's stuffed in a shoebox in an old nylon stocking, and how gentleman really cares for it. The first stanza gives explanation. The poet finds a baby mouse small enough to cradle in Roethke's big hand. The little creature's whole body trembling, almost sure to die if left alone in the meadow. So not only mouse, even human being will tremble if left alone in unsituation or unfamiliar environment. So likewise, the mouse is unfamiliar with new surroundings and it is very scared. Here Roethke projects himself as animal loving person and very sensitive person who empathizes over the poor little creatures. The poet described about the appearance of mouse. His feet looks like shaggy leaf shaped lizard, which imprints like cotton mouse. And his whole body trembling with fear, or maybe he tries to wriggle away using his white, spread whitish legs. As soon as possible, the little mouse gets closer and gets comfortable with our author after eating three kinds of cheese and drinking from its bottle cap watering trough, which was given by our author. After he had a different kinds of cheese and water, it just lies in one corner and it curled up like small baby and sleeping very peacefully with its bulging belly, and its ears are looks like a twitching, I mean sudden jerking and turning towards the sound, and it trying to adapt in new home. So in the first stanza, we can easily able to recognize that Roethke uses lot of words like baby, cradle, little, puppy to explain readers that he really treats mouse as his old child. So move on to second stanza. The next morning, empty box makes him wonder how his little mouse has gone. So he is scared about little mouse won't be able to defend itself, as it comes around the bottom and can easily eaten by the predators. The poet questions himself. He questions the mode of its going, fearing danger from the hawk, owl, tomcat or snake. The gentle poet worries about tiny mouse will get struggles which can cause bad efforts to him by other wild creatures. So, most of the people usually didn't care about the creatures. They questioned themselves why should they care about the pet. But in this poem, author cares about animal or the field mouse which looks like his childhood. There is no any more moral issues in this poem at all. But it is about love between human and animal. Finally, Roethke makes a human correlation, human connection that he discovery about human conditions and parental worries over a child. So we don't know what will happen to him. Like said in the last sentence, all things innocent, helpless and forsaken. Even though the world is fraught with danger in natural scheme of things, every parent knows their children will leave the safe environment of home to seek his own fortune in this dangerous world. And parents must be let their child to go far for their good shakiness and same as poet do to the field mouse. Thank you.